I'm a writer, organizer, activist, mother. I run an organization, Write Out Loud, Transforming Our Lives Through Writing Our Truths, and the basic mission of that is to empower individuals to write their own stories as a means of healing and hopefully grassroots organizing. You know, they can take that writing, that sense of empowerment back to their communities and build them up. How I connected with Daryl prior to that, a year before that, I was trying to do a project called Voices Carry, and it was going to help elicit or engage the voices of women behind bars at Framingham Prison, and that was in the Bay State banner, and it was a very exciting project. Unfortunately, Framingham Prison personnel bureaucracy ran me in such circles that I wasn't able to get into prison. There wasn't any room. They lost my proposal. That the project kind of fizzled out. Nothing happened with it. And then I got a call saying that Daryl was wondering what happened with that. And I actually got a couple calls from other people at the same time, like, what happened with that? And I was disappointed and ashamed to say that nothing happened with it, because I had kind of the silencing technique of Framingham State Prison had worked on me, and so it fizzled. So, you know, in connecting with Joanna and speaking with Daryl, it was reborn again as the visiting room. And he said something interesting to me, that when he first read about the Voices Carry project a year ago, he was like, oh, this was hope. This was, you know, and I felt a huge responsibility leaving there. Like, I have to get these voices out. These people need to be heard. And the media lockout that needs to be addressed. So if I have to be a one woman band noisemaker to make that happen, then I came out fully committed to that, to this project moving forward, and not to be silenced. You know, I realized that the same tools that have been used to silence me are used on a daily basis to silence the prisoners. The only difference is I'm able to bounce back and recover from it because I have other things to re-energize me. But if you're locked inside, and people take away that basic right to be able to express yourself to others and cut you off from others, then that it's like a death sentence. Daryl is not at all what I expected. He is very charismatic and I told my husband I thought that maybe he worked there because he's all pressed and starched and the glasses and very dignified, and you know, I was taken aback a little, like, oh, okay, I don't know what I envisioned. By the time we got to see him, my hopes for anything positive were kind of dashed. So meeting him was refreshing because he was articulate, he was on point, he knew what he wanted. And I hate to describe a black man as being, oh, he was articulate, like, that's so out of the norm. But that's only because the whole experience there was already so jumbled and funky that he was refreshing to, you know, meet someone who was honest and who could clearly state, you know, what they thought of my work and what they believe the pressing issue, you know, within those walls were. He emanates a very positive energy, a very, you know, real energy. As I was speaking to him, you know, other prisoners were like giving him dap, like, oh, I appreciate what you said. And I saw that he himself is a source of hope for these men. And they look to him like, you know, if Daryl can do this, then, you know, we'll be fine. We'll be fine if he's here. You know, almost like a comforting effect. You know, you could listen to him for hours. Actually, I did, and not realize that hours are passing, because he's just that charismatic. But he's not a slickster. It's not, you know, it's a real person you're talking. He's not like somebody that's all slick and, you know, he keeps it real. And so what you get from him is you get this kinetic, his energy. It's like, how can you walk away from this person and not do anything? Like, you would have to be, you know, really just disconnected from humanity to walk away from him and not be motivated to do something about what's going on within Massachusetts prisons. The importance of silence in Darryl is simply he will shut down business. Like if he is successful in getting these young men or these older men to communicate and he gets a positive message within them and they carry it out into their communities, then the recidivism rate, that's going to drop. Like one person can do that, like Gandhi shut down England, you know, it can happen, you know. So, I mean, he literally shut down England, but he liberated his people. Martin Luther King liberated his folks. So if Darryl is successful, if he's allowed to speak, then the whole big business of prison in Massachusetts will be affected. And they can't even have a little dent in that business. That is a moneymaker. And they don't want to be exposed for what it is. It's a business. You know, we bring people in. We don't rehabilitate them, as according to our mission statement. And we send them back out because we want them back. You know, and Darryl is very vocal about this is how you don't come back here, and then also letting those on the outside know this is what's happening here. They're not being rehabilitated. And so, like I said, he's stopping them from making their money. You know, he's the one in the factory line, like pushing the stop button, like let's stop manufacturing criminals.